The following video is a display of depravity, stupidity, and intelligence, sophistication, and lowbrow humor. If you continue to watch, we cannot guarantee your sanity and sensitivity. All content and views of the following individuals are wrong and right in all regards. You have been warned. Buckle up.
You have been warned. Buckle up for the show.
Buckle up for the show.
Hey viewers, Zombie Barney here. Obviously, you knew that. Anywho, so I'm starting a new corner of my channel, if you would. It's the JRPG corner. For those of you that don't know what that means, that's Japanese role-playing game. I'm sure a lot of you do know what that means. Anywho, we're starting off by playing what's on the screen right now, Grand Kingdom. I've played this game before. I've probably had already put in about 2 weeks worth of time playing it, maybe some along there. No, maybe not that much time, but I put in a lot. And I'm really hoping it's not really loud right now. Like, for me, it's really loud, but I turned down my capture card video game sound, or audio, if you would. I turned that way down to 37 because I usually keep it on 66, and I keep my volume at 45, but, so, I recorded this once before, and the game audio was just unbelievably loud, and as you can see, there's no option menu right here at the start screen, which is a flaw to me, because A, the game starts you off with all the voice acting being in English, which I don't like. I actually prefer the Japanese voice acting, and once I get the option to change that, we'll be changing or swapping right on over to that. And B, I can't adjust the audio sounds or turn off music or anything like that. Anywho, though, but for not just this game, but for the entirety of this corner of my channel, the JRPG corner, it's completely unmonetized. I'm doing it for free, and it's mainly because of the music. JRPGs tend to have really beautiful music to them, and I don't want to have to turn the music off while I'm playing it. It takes out a lot of the life of the game for me. So, yeah. And I think it's a lot better for viewers to watch, listening, I completely lost where I was going with that. Anywho, we're gonna start. Where was I going with that? Anywho, Grand Kingdom's really fun. It's definitely turn-based, and I'm gonna turn up autoplay.
We got him cornered, boss. The bastards have no chance of winning now.
You got us. We surrender. Just please don't kill us.
Look, we gotta make a living too, so no hard feelings, all right?
Yeah.
That battle cry.
I don't even know how well you guys can hear all this, honestly.
Those noble pricks are giving up.
I'm hoping pretty well.
Work, and it was all for nothing. Nothing sadder than sticking around when you've been beat. Let's get out of here, boss.
Do you want us to just stay like this then?
If you enjoy being on your knees with your hands up, hold that pose as long as you want.
I'm lowering my hands. Don't attack me, all right?
Yeah, right. Like we dirty our swords for nothing. The price of your heads fell to less than one copper just now. Anyway, what are we gonna do, boss? It doesn't look like we'll be getting much of a reward now. We can't afford to bask in the glow of defeat. We need to figure out how we're gonna feed our men.
Hey, are you guys headed for anywhere in particular? Because if not, do you want to come with us?
Yo, boss. This guy hasn't shut up yet.
Yeah, I can see that.
Members of a mercenary outfit known as the Guild. I'm asking if you want to join us.
The Guild? The mercenary organization led by the Master Swordsman Godfrey.
Though you were an enemy, you showed it.
Has some keen exposition.
It would be a shame to let you leave. And I also owe you my life.
Well, you heard the man. What do you want to do, boss?
Doesn't actually give me an option, just makes the game start.
100 years have passed since the fall of the Ulbane Empire. The long, brutal war left the four great nations crippled honor and virtue have become distant memories. Now, in the great continent of Resenail, the battlefield is no longer dominated by knights, but by mercenaries. Some fight to put food on their table. Others fight for bounteous wealth. They plunge headlong into the jaws of death, not for any nation, but for the glint of gold. Mercenaries who live in an age of war, let their story be told.
Here we go, episode one. Okay, and
we have high standards for our mercenaries.
Okay, before I let this continue on, actually no. I'll just let go.
Proof of your power first. Doesn't matter who introduced you. No exceptions. You lot have two choices: take the test or take a hike.
Really doesn't seem like much of a choice, boss.
Yeah, I already know all this stuff. Okay. So, but before I really continue on, this is gonna be episodic by the storyline quest. I'm not gonna be recording, you know, side missions or me out in the, quote-unquote, free roam area and all that. That's where you go off and you grind up levels and stuff like that. I'm just gonna be showing off the story here. And so this is really a let's play. It's not a walkthrough of anything like that. And if I can apply, like, a certain build to go with, then yeah, I might, like, showcase that, but... no promises. And that's kind of just like how this whole JRPG corner thing is going to be, is me just doing the main story of something that I'm playing. Yeah, I know that. Like, for instance, something that's going to be coming up eventually in November, unless it gets pushed back again, is going to be good old Final Fantasy 15. And I'm going to... I probably won't be done with this by the time Final Fantasy 15 rolls around. So when that comes by and everything, this will go on hold, and I'll just exclusively do Final Fantasy 15 for a bit till I'm done with the story on that, and then I'll come back to this, do this, and move on to another JRPG after this is done. Yada 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 yada. Let's get this fight on the road. All right. Yeah. So looking at it, almost had him. Now, I could definitely have him with this attack. Boom, take him out. And then it just only leaves me getting hit by two attacks. Or I could weaken like him, but it won't kill him more than likely. I mean, I just don't have faith in this hunter, so... I like to focus fire something down to limit and mitigate how much damage I'm about to take, rather than setting everything up so that I can just flourish them all down at once. So, we're gonna do this. He's dead. Probably would have been a lot better if I could have just taken him out the first time with a warrior. Wants me to do light. Gotcha. Yep, medical bag. Boom. Boom. We're just gonna put that there. Alright, so what I can do to try to mitigate this situation is I want to try to get to where that leader is and take him out with the cleric or the Yeah, I'm just gonna call her cleric, because she heals, whatever. But I don't really have the necessary movement to be able to, because the game wanted me to put down a medical bag for the tutorial and everything. That's what this is. The tutorial is long in this game. Holy shit, is it long. And that's probably like the first two or three episodes of this, so... But looking at my setup, as she moves, I've got old guard person and everything. So, this is best situation. Not guard person, not a warrior. Boom. See, now I'm just like I'm doing a flourish, which is not what I like to do. And problem solved. Yeah! Nope. Don't want to do it again. My troop is at full HP. I don't need to do that. I can't do that. Yeah. Anywho, invis enemy. That's the thing on this field. Okay, so like this game goes by like a strategic field, like a board, as if it's like a board game, if you would. And then it does this part where it's a three lane strategy fight going on. So you got to plan things out. You got the bottom there, which is essentially your. I go by like Final Fantasy Tactics and I look at it as like CT, right? So it's really just your turn order. You can't do anything to affect who comes first and stuff like that, except for unless you're using a charge move, which you've seen one in the last battle with the mage there, who's actually a witch, when she did lightning. Because of the tutorial and everything, he made it so that she didn't really have to wait to do it, but normally that's a charge move and she has to charge it up for a moment and then shoots it. So, alright. Looking at the situation. If anything, I think what I should probably do is see if I can get all the way down to him. Ah, you see that? See, he's actually a bit out, and considering the attacks I have, this isn't a really good option there. So, honestly, going for this first wolf is the best option. There we go. Alright, so I got this other wolf to deal with. And I'm gonna have faith that my hunter there can take it out. So what I'm gonna do instead with her. You also gotta be careful with the buttons you press on this because it's weird having axes cancel. Cool. There we go. And this battle will be solved. All in first turn. So, since I'm skipping a lot of things that are being read and everything like that, because it'd be my... fourth time, I guess, doing that. TP is troop points, which is used for like opening chests, doing actions out on the field or the strategic board, if you would. Like, there we go. See, skills right here, TP costs. So, yeah. Excuse me. And then you got something like morale, which is affected. Oh, okay. Yes. Now, you see, normally in a regular mission, you avoid as much as possible getting into senseless fights, because you want to get from point A to point B as fast as possible, gathering up as many resources as possible. So I'm actually going to avoid this guy. And what I just did there is you can see with that puff of smoke that was two spaces ahead of where my current symbol is pointing at. That is a invisible enemy, and I was standing by letting him do his whole little route to get ahead of me so that I didn't have to fight him as well. And there's another situation of that. Now, this is a treasure chest where I can just open. It doesn't cost any TP because it's not locked. And hidden route. Another one of those treasure chests. And gold! With boss fight. Yep, 2-part. And I haven't taken any damage, so I'm all good to do this. Yep. Alright, so, what they have is two warriors right there, and unless they want to eliminate their own blockade, this is great, because what I can do strategically with my warrior, or fighter is what they're actually called, it's not warrior, I just prefer warrior, I guess, I can actually technically block these guys in, but I want to do it in a manner where I can only get attacked by one per turn, and... There we go. That's probably be good enough. Doopy? Alright, now, I have 3 ranged characters. This puts me at a really good advantage. There we go. Ah, fucked up. Now, which one should I go for? Right? That's a good question here. But I broke that guy's guard. He's leader. He's at lower health. He's an easier kill. Should probably go for him. Man, I have not played this in a while. Originally, I was gonna, the JRPG Corner was gonna be a whole thing to stream, but my internet is not good enough. And that is... That's very sad. Makes me very, very sad. Alright, another acid throw here. Breaks the guard. Oh, did a decent amount of damage as well. I'm not sure, like, what's the damage modification on the cleric. So. And he's down for the count. Yep, let's go ahead. Tell me about objects, things like that. Okay, so. There's that sign, I forget what that means during the tutorial, that sign and everything, it doesn't really matter. Usually, the AIs have signs put up to mean that there's something on the field going on. That box reduces range damage. Not magic damage, range damage. So, my hunter here won't be as good against that hunter. So, technically speaking, my witch should be the one to attack that hunter. And what should I do here? Let's see, I could run up, attack that guy, get some damage in, probably won't kill him. And then it leaves me pretty defenseless. But they have a good advantage here. I can use... Yeah, I'm gonna run up and attack. Because I've got the initiative. Oh, almost got his ass. And it's tutorial, so he's going to either. Alright. So cancel. We're gonna do that. Broke his guard. That's good enough. Come on, stay grouped up. I've never seen that before. Oh, that's glorious. Oh, I feel so good about that. Alright. I'm gonna take this guy out because honestly, he's gonna be a problem if I don't. Ah, fucked up. And now she's doing lightning, which is a problem and a half for me. So I'm gonna cancel here. I'm gonna move him over, go back a little bit, boom, and there we go. And, mind you, this team, I'm not even going to be keeping this team. This is the, tutorial team in the game. Oh my god, clerics. They have no goddamn weight. Yeah, no, I didn't need it. Don't care, this is over. See, notice how down there above, I just hit square for lightning and make her lightning go after my fighter gets his turn back. So I'm not gonna do that. There we go. Should've been able to do that on the first turn, but I fucked it up. Cause I'm not, it's been a while of playing, and with my original team that I did, when I found, before I found out that you can only have one save file per, PlayStation account for this game. It was supposed to be my offline account. I had a Dark Knight, a Dragon Mage, and a Fighter. So I wasn't ever really using the sliding attacks like that. But man, was I wrecking things with it. It was a slow team, though. It was a slow team. It was very defensive for a team.
I see. You're quite experienced. Though your troop was hastily assembled, you commanded without hesitation. Very well. I approve your entry to the guild. If you're finished, introduce yourselves to the guild leader. There, you'll officially be one of us.
Press clear, yay! Awesome. Okay. It's gonna be the whole intro story, if you would.
So you must be the mercenaries we recruited from our most recent battle.
Yes, we are, Bato.
I'll have you tell me your names first.
Okay. I now have some... I'm not even gonna say it. Anyway, my name is going to be... Captain Boss. Yep. Yeah. You'll see why. Dim guys. That's the name of my mercenary faction. Or squad name, whatever. Dim guys. I'm Godfrey
Sforza, the leader of this guild. I observed your test. You are indeed skilled.
And you must use Visine all the time, because it's some clear-ass eyes you got there, boy.
Rather confident, aren't you? As you should be. We'd have no use for you otherwise.
Damn!
Lilia, you're here. Perfect. Introduce yourself.
Certainly. I'm Lilia. As of today, I will be acting as your assistant. Pleased to make your acquaintance.
Assistant? What's all this about?
I understand your confusion, but this is a guild custom. Trust her to take care of operations and your other day-to-day responsibilities.
Uh-huh.
That way, you can focus on your missions.
Uh-huh.
What are we gonna do, boss? There's no way we can bring this chick into battle with us.
You'll need someone to handle communications and clerical duties. She will be very helpful and will not hinder you in any way.
Don't blame me if anything happens to her.
Like, a lot of the English voice acting just sounds
mercenaries' occupations depend
really freaking stiff to me.
Work hard for yourselves, but above all, work hard for the good of the guild.
It seems everyone is here. Now then, I will guide you through each of the guild's facilities.
Wait a sec, we can do that later. Boss, we gotta drink first.
Why don't we see, he calls me boss.
Well, the sun is still so high. A day wasted is a fortune lost. I believe we should take care of things while we have the chance.
Boss, you ever heard this proverb?
It seems you're both not familiar with it.
I got a proverb for you. A level a day keeps the Balrog away.
It's a very wise proverb. You should remember it for the days to come.
Jeez, you say the most confusing things. Don't tell me you got a bunch of proverbs in that thick notebook you got there.
I do. Is that a problem? These proverbs are the wisdom of Godfrey, the master swordsman.
Proverbs or not, the boss and I don't have time for that crap. What we need right now is a drink. Guide us to the tavern.
It would seem your captain is more interested in the guild's facilities.
Seriously, boss?
Yeah, Flit!
Allow me to guide you to the recruitment office first.
See, she calls me captain, so captain boss. That's how I came up with the name. Yep. Alright. Let's see what we can get here, shall we? Yep. Alright, so we got a hunter, we got a fighter, which we're definitely going to be picking up the fighter more than likely. Okay, so this is interesting. Surprisingly, I'm not gonna- oh, but it's medic, that's what she's called. Cleric medic, same thing, really. I'm not gonna be picking up a medic, actually, because there's a skill that you can acquire in order to, for every troop to be able to heal themselves by, like, 20 or 30%. It's 30%, yeah. Takes up a whole bunch of, action points and everything like that, or, well, you've got your action gauge, you got your movement gauge, it takes up a whole bunch of the action gauge. So. I think what I'm gonna do, actually, is go fighter, rogue, damn, 9 bonus points to start off with, I like that. You got earth heal, overkill, weak down, last attack. Do I wanna go with him? Just trying to think this through right now. Let's see. Okay, first off, I'm going for him, definitely. Yeah, we'll choose that name. Changing body colors though. I'll give you that, why not? I guess that's... nah. Kinda hard to decide! Yeah, I guess we'll go with that. That face is fine, whatever. Gutsy for the voice, let's play that voice.
What are you thinking?
With that face, no. Okay, we'll go with that. Fuck the pitch, I don't give a shit about the pitch. Alright, so he's really gonna be defensive. He's gonna be a tank for me, so I need stamina, I need spirit. Strength, okay, affects physical attack power, stamina, affects physical damage resistance, magic attack. Spirit, magic defense. Tech affects experience, and apparently, like, how well you can block attacks, apparently. So, that was an interesting one when I learned that. Agility affects quickness, move gauge, recovery rate. Vitality is, like, the same, but for action gauge, constitution is maximum health, and SP is for support skills. Never pour anything into SP, ever. That's how it would be for any of the builds I would ever possibly do in the future. So, for this guy, I want to kind of focus those and vitality for the action gauge. Generally, I say just focus on 4 for most characters. Some people might not agree with me, but hey, that's you and this is me. Yeah, I don't fuck your advice for the medic. Alright. So I'm thinking, like, gender equality for a team, right? So 2 guys, 2 girls, maybe? And I would like, I guess, 2 melee and 2 range. So having her would be good. And I either go for Valkyrie girl. Or not Valkyrie, blacksmith. Or rogue. One of the two. So, I guess first I'll just grab her, because she's range, so. I don't like her lone wolf ability. Okay, yeah, we can go with Teresa for name. Do I want that? I guess we'll go with this. What the? Somebody just... Oh, no. Phone's charged. Okay. They're a purple hat? Not really. So we can go with, like, super purple right there. Oh, actually, I don't want to use hats. Shit, that's right. So, we're gonna give her white hair. No. Black hair actually fits. Oh god, no.
Judgment has come.
Nope.
Just die already. Yeah, I can do it. Go all out. Finish them.
Okay, why not? Okay, so she's gonna need magic. She's gonna need some movement gauge and some vitality. She doesn't really need constitution. She doesn't need tech. I think in her situation, her being a witch, kind of build her beak, glass cannon really. Gotta be able to move and be able to just hit a lot at the same time as well. So really it'll just be these 3 stats. Okay. Alright, so either her bonus points are 4. Vital drain. Huh. strength is at E. It was her. Ooh, strength is at D. 9 bonus points. The rogues are good for getting behind enemy lines and taking out, like, high-value targets, really, right? So, like, a high-value target to me, essentially, is a ranged character most of the time. Ones that you would find the most annoying because they'll try to sit back and make sure that you do not fuck with them, while the other AI units end up fucking with you all the time. So I like the idea of having a rogue. Excuse me. 12. Oh man, choosing. This is a hard choice for me. See, she's good for being able to just rush in and attack, but her starter bonus points, I cannot agree with. It's not like this team, I'm going to stick with, like, all these characters through the entire thing. I will eventually get a better version of this team, but I'm going to be trying to stay with some consistency for the sake of the videos. So, whatever team I stick with is what you guys can see on camera. Do I want 2 range, 2 melee? Oh man, decisions. I love the idea of having a rogue, but I can see the proper uses of using the blacksmith as well. I gotta go for rogue. I've got to. Those bonus points. And the strength. Man, yeah. Oh, actually, wait a second. That's what I want to see. Ah, that's... I don't know if I like the headband. We'll go with that skin color because I haven't chosen that. Or I haven't gotten that one yet. And where's the purple? That's the purple. Gotcha. Okay. I guess that pretty much does it. I guess we'll go with that. Alright, so she'll need strength. Oop, my eye. Ow. Agility and vitality for sure. Being able to move, being able to attack. And I really think that's kind of all she needs. Because I don't think they get any magic attacks. And the point of her isn't really, like, you know, she's a rogue, she's high DPS. So she's supposed to... I guess I wouldn't necessarily play her as, like, a rogue, but more like an assassin. If possible, because my idea is for her to go invis, sneak in behind enemy lines, take out the high priority targets. So, I guess this is how I want to do it. Yep. Alright. So, I have 2 glass cannons. I can't go with him, even though he's ranged. Yeah, I can't. Because he'd be a lot like the witch. Well, end up being like the glass cannon. Can't go with him, same story. So really, I can only go with him and keep the gender equality, if you would. Or I can go with her, have 3 girls, 1 guy. But he's 9 bonus points too. Ooh, and he has Blizzard. That's awesome. And Sub-Leader. Yeah, I'm going with this guy. Albert. We're gonna go with that for you, Albert. I guess we can keep that face. There we go. That kind of matches the off teal, if you would. Yeah, we'll go with that. Alright, so who'll need strength? Who'll need agility and vitality? And let's see, so I go stamina or spirit. I'm thinking stamina because he'll be kind of there to be mitigating some of the physical damage on the way in. If everything plays out right, I wouldn't have to worry about getting hit by magic necessarily. So yeah, those four stats. Boop boop, boopity boop. And strength is your main stat. Yeah, I know. Still can't mess with sounds or anything just yet. But you know what, first. Now then. Oh yeah, see, this was the move I was talking about. Takes up 230 in the action gauge, range own uses 3, but use medicine recovers 30% HP. I can get 4 of those, teach it to everybody, and bada boopy, I don't need a medic. I'm not gonna do that right now. First, I need to worry about getting weapons. So I need one of those, one of these, oh, one of those. Ruby cane, there we go. That and anything else? Doesn't look like it. Alright. Gear. We're gonna grab that and 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 that. Ooh, yes, of course, I can get all 4. Awesome. Objects. You'll see what this is about here in a second. You saw. Go ahead and grab one of these. So you saw how, like, the enemies had objects on the field and everything. I can actually end up putting my own objects down eventually. That's right, there's no voice acting right here. There we go. And now voice acting! Explanation of the guild's facilities. It's a lot to take. I think they only did that because they didn't want to pay for a voice actor just for the shopkeeper.
We're finally at the inn. It's nighttime already? And what's with this crowd of people? Is the guild's inn always like this?
It seems those troublemakers are at it again.
Sure enough.
What? Done already? It seems the only mighty thing about you is your mouth.
Vice, that's 99 wins for you! No one can beat the White Wolf mercenaries!
Take one down and pass it around.
Damn, what's going on here?
Vice, how many times must you be told before it finally sinks in? Causing trouble within the guild is not allowed. Are you deliberately defying my father's orders?
Oh, it's just you, Maria. I don't care if you're the guild leader's daughter. Keep your opinions to yourself. Anyway, who are those guys behind you?
They're the newest members of the guild.
They're dim guys!
Boss, Vice is one of those White Wolf mercenaries we saw in battle earlier today. So they're with the guild too. How interesting.
So, you're the captain. Your squad really stood out on the battlefield today. Pity we never got a chance to fight each other.
Are you itching for a fight?
No,
I'll decline for now. Normally, I wouldn't shy away from a challenge. You'd be my 100th victory. But this place is unworthy of hosting it. Until next time.
What's that guy's problem?
Later, douche!
He's a brute who challenges other squads and takes their flags as proof of his victory. You should be wary of him, Captain.
What's the point of taking a squad's flag? Jeez, I can't imagine fighting someone for free.
I will report this incident to my father as well. I need to tell him that this sort of behavior must not be tolerated.
Well, a lot of stuff happened today, but now I can finally get my drink on! Boss, how long has it been? Let's celebrate by getting rip-roaring drunk!
Auto saving! Yeah, okay. Oh, now I can finally go to the party menu. First thing on the agenda is adjusting some options. Alright. All volume here. Oh wait, actually first let's do boom. Alright, so all volume here. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11? Wait, what? Okay, so there's nothing. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Alright, so I'm not mistaken. Let's put it down to that? No, that may be. Alright, so now I should be adjusting the sound on my, capture software back up to what it normally is. Oop. There we go. See, one more. Maybe that's good enough. No, let's go back down. Okay. Now, hopefully that's coming out right. Like, just fucking hopefully, man. Oh, it'd be a bitch. I have to fucking figure out a way to solve the problem. Yeah, save the adjusted settings. Ow! Alright, so, equipment. Yep. Steel longsword. Large steel shield. Bronze ring. Bronze bangle. Ruby cane. Bronze ring. Bronze bangle. Hand dagger. Ring. Got a pike. Ring. Bronze ring. Yeah, the purzine is it's just augmentations, essentially, you know, slots. It's a common RPG thing to deal with. Not deal with, but it helps modify your character. Generally, I like to go for what affects the actual stats of my character rather than minute things like, oh, you can block this much more damage or something like that. Which, I mean, I do see the value in that, but I just kind of like getting all the stats up as much as possible. The stats that I actually have to care about, that is. Alright, now I want to look at skills. I'm going to start off with Mason here. Go. So there's technical or simple. Right, I actually prefer playing with technical over simple. Because with simple, it would always go 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3 for my attacking. With technical, I could actually do like circle, triangle, circle, triangle, circle, triangle. Go back between slash and side edge, back to slash, back to side edge. If I want to, it gives me more control over what I'm doing. Which feels amazing. Okay. So you have fire spell, lightning. Same thing for this girl. Let's see. Do I want guard for everybody to be on circle? I guess. So we're gonna put hide here. I like page A to actually be my attacks while I have page B as like supplementary skills, if you would. Oh yeah, that's right. Frost Rocket Spear Blow. I've actually never used a Lancer before, so let's look at these skills real quick. Okay. Gotcha. Okay. Nope, not what I want to go to. I want to go to status, because what I want to look at is, here we go. Ability, last attack plus. Last attack by 20%. Not that bad. Weak down, increase the symbol enemy's attack defense. That is great! Oh! And cancels downpour and lava. That is honestly really good. I'm not a big fan of last attack plus, not on a defensive character like this guy. Hopefully we'll end up being, because the fighters get a AoE guard skill called Total Guard where they can block for everybody, and it's amazing. Yeah, okay. That's actually not that bad. Enemy warp. Lone wolf. We only need a leader is left. Increases. I mean, I guess I can make her the leader if she has that, but I don't know. Overkill, which is great. It's fucking awesome. And I love that she has Earth Heal. Quicksand and Gorge, alright. Subleader, nullifies the effects of the leader list for the troop. And he has Blizzard, which also gets rid of Downpour and Lava. That gets rid of Downpour and Lava. Huh. Okay. Formation, here we go. See, this is where you can, it's a formation where you can assign how your units are placed. Invasion, defense, depending on the mission, depends on whether you're bringing a defensive person out on the field or whether you're bringing a defensive person out on the field, and you would see the differences eventually through me playing this. Right now, all I really have to worry about is invasion. So I'm gonna move that back there, move that back there. And I have this place in, everybody placed in a pretty good spot. I can move up one more if I really want to. But, so, like, say for instance, I end up going up against a team of full blacksmiths. They tend to have really good movement and high action. They would end up going before my fighter would be able to. If I was up by one more, they could at least reach me and hit me once. And then they would typically go into a guard. But if I'm back this far, they generally cannot reach me with their attacks. So, this is, generally speaking, the best position that I've figured out so far. And let's go ahead and do this. The exact same for this. Boop. Boop. There we go. Ow, my arm. And I did put the voice acting on Japanese, right? Cool. Is there anything else to do? I'm trying to think here, and I don't think there is. Don't care about mercenary equipment, I ain't got shit. Don't care about renaming the troop. Yeah, I think it's pretty much... Yep. Now it wants me to... Yep. Alright, so this would pretty much go into episode 2. I'm gonna stop this video right here and we'll go ahead and go into the next episode. And, yeah. See you on the next one.